I have known beautiful Melissa since we were little kids. As we got older, we got incredibly close. I got really spoiled because Melissa calls me one day and she's like, I'm graduating college. I'm not sure what I want to do. And I was like, yeah, you could move and come back to New Mexico and like live with me if you want. And she was like, yeah, I guess I will. So this amazing friend of mine comes and moves in with us. Well, she's with us for a couple months. And Tony one day goes, do you remember my friend John King, right? He like did a band with us, One for Hope. So if you saw that picture in there, John has like the rocker hair and he's jamming out. This is this face. So he goes, oh my God, he's one of my dearest friends. We live together, we grew up together. He's like, he's back from Portland and we're gonna get a drink tonight. You should come with us. Oh, sure. So I remembered walking into the brewery. I walk up to John and I literally got goosebumps. And I went, oh my God, he looks like one of the Beatles. He's totally Melissa's type. I got shivers. I was like, man, he's in a rock band. That's totally Melissa's type. So I'm sitting there, and as much as I was getting to know John just as my man's friend, I was doing like deep work, spy work, as the best friend. I'm like, who are you? What kind of man are you? And I'm getting to know this man who's just this beautiful person. I find out he's an artist, and Melissa has been an artist, and she expresses it through dance, and she expresses it through her passion in life. And I knew, oh man, this needs to happen. Love.